let us move to the humanitarian assistance, since we will never agree on that. As I was coming to you, five babies, newborn babies, died in Al Shifa Hospital because they had no oxygen, no power. We have a major issue of power in Gaza. Why are we not, Israel is not allowing fuel to get into Gaza or two hospitals, 20 hospitals are out of service now. What are you going to do regarding the fuel?
There is fuel available in the south for hospitals, for desalination plants, for delivery of humanitarian assistance. And we are confident that fuel will continue to be available in the south. With respect to the north, Hamas has had its hand on the fuel which supplies the hospitals. You should address your question to Hamas on the circumstances within those hospitals, particularly Shifa. But that said, Tony Blinken, our Secretary of State, very, very forcefully has said, when you see the image of a dead infant, a dead child, you think of your own children. It's gut-wrenching. It is a kick in the gut. Those are his words. We feel that. How can you not feel that way? We want to see the campaign conducted in a manner that respects, to the maximum extent possible, humanitarian sites, that respects civilians, even though this terrorist group has deliberately chosen to use these sites to embed its own facilities. Nevertheless, it needs to be done.
So again, you mean that all the assistance, all the fuel will go to the south, but nothing to the north. The north should die.
I didn't say that. What I said was currently fuel is being supplied to hospitals and desalination plants in the south. Are there needs in the north? Yes, absolutely there are. And we are hopeful that assistance can reach the north where it is needed and where it is not diverted by Hamas to power the ventilators in its tunnels to allow it to continue its terror can be done.